In this lecture, we will see the density of states. And first, let me introduce what is the meaning of density of state. So, density of states, or in short, DOS, is the number of energy states available per unit energy per unit volume. So this is the definition of density of state, that is number of energy states available for electrons in a given band per unit energy and per unit band. And the next question is, why do we need this density of state? It is because to describe the IV characteristic or anything where we need the number of charge carriers, but here I am talking in terms of IV. So to describe the IV characteristics of semiconductors, or semiconductor devices, it is important to determine the number of electrons and holes in the semiconductor that will be available for conduction, available for conduction. So we need to determine the number of charge carriers in a semiconductor to describe the IV characteristic, and for this reason we have to first determine the number of energy states available in a particular energy, and if we divide that number by a particular volume or volume occupied by that carriers, then we can find this density of states. Here I am using a very simple method to understand this density of states. So for this, first let's take a let's assume a slab of a material or a semiconductor, whatever you want to say it. So this is the if I make it in 3D, as you know my drawing is very bad, so I'm trying to it looks like a slab. And if I write here two points, that is one point here is T, and for here let another point P. And if this distance or length is LX, let's say this is X axis, this is Y, and this is Z axis, LX. So if this is a semiconductor slab or a piece of semiconductor or a piece of material, whatever you want to say it, if an electron moves in X direction, then its wave function should be obey boundary condition. Of the slab and its wave function should be terminated at T and P points. So if an electron moves in X direction, then its wave function should obey the boundary condition of this slab. Look, this. So if I draw a simple wave here, it's not exactly like an electron, but for simplicity, let's draw a wave like this. So this wave is obeying the boundary condition that it is going to terminate at this edge and also at this edge. And as I said earlier, that due to this boundary condition, a traveling electron wave behaves like a standing wave. So here we know that a traveling electron wave in a crystal or in a material behaves like a standing wave. So here we can write that this wave function is a superposition of sine and cosine waves. As I learned earlier, that standing waves are the combination of sine and cosine waves. So similarly, here we can write electron wave function as a linear combination of sine and cosine waves. So A sine AX plus B cos KX. So this is the linear combination of, and if we apply boundary conditions, such that kx equal to n pi, where n equal to 0, 1, 2, 3, that is integer, So from here we can get k equal to n pi by x. As earlier we know that how can we write this k or wave vector, and if we use this dimension that is lx, then instead of x we can write here lx, that is k equal to n pi by lx. And for n equal to 1 we know that k equal to pi by lx, k equal to pi by lx. And it is very important to note this point. Now you have to understand it very carefully, that a state of an electron or a particle means it must be follow the boundary conditions in 3D, that is a single state and what is the meaning of the single state? It is space required by an electron must be equal to, this is in k direction, so we can write this is kx, equal to kx ky kz, which is equal to pi over lx if we take direction in x, and pi equal to ly and pi equal to lz. If lx equal to ly equal to lz equal to l, then volume of state which is equal to pi 3 by l 3. So it is the minimum volume required or acquired by an electron in k space. Meaning here is that if we want to the number of energy states, then we have to know what is the minimum energy state required for an electron. In if we take a very simple example, that this is the area and we want to fill this area by some cricket ball, and we have And now we have to calculate how many balls can fit this area. This may be area 2D or in 3D. Then first we have to know the size of this ball, and then we have to know the size of this space. Then by dividing this size to this side, this size, we can get the number of balls that can we have in this area. Similarly, but here we are using physical dimension, but for density of states, instead of physical dimension, we have to use momentum dimension in momentum. So let's say this is the volume in K space. Then if we know what is the minimum volume that is required by an electron, if somehow we can know this volume of an electron, then by dividing this volume, we can get the number of electrons that can fill this volume, or number of electrons that we can have in this volume. So in K space, this is the, that is pi over Lx, this is the area or linear in x direction that is required for an electron. And in three dimension, this is the volume, minimum volume that is required by an electron. So by dividing this volume to the whole volume of that space in momentum, we can get the number of density states. So here, now by an electron in K space. Therefore, I'm writing now the same thing. Therefore, for getting number of states mean number of energy states in the given K space, we have to divide the volume space by volume of a single state, that is pi 3, that is the volume of a single state. And here, from here, we can get only the number of energy states, but we have to determine the number of energy states per unit volume, per unit energy. So for those, that is number of energy states density of states, that is density per unit, I'm writing it here again, per unit volume, per unit energy. We have to divide, I think here divide number of states by volume and given energy. So now let VA is the volume of a single state, that is, as I written earlier, that is VA, which is equal to pi by Lx into pi by Ly into pi by Lz, which is equal to pi by L by 3, and when Lx equal to Ly equal to Lz equal to L, then this will be VA equal to, so as I written above, that is pi over L into this one. So for this we have to draw let's take a sphere where this is the so if this is the volume in which we have to determine the density of state and this is in K space, so first we have to know the volume of a single state, that is, if I draw a single state here, we can draw some small volume of an electron like this. This is a small volume. So this is the volume of a single electron, or volume that can, minimum volume that can have by an electron. But so for this, if I write here 3 point P, Q and R, and we note that the volume between P, Q and R is the 1/8 volume of the sphere. To determine the number of energy states in a sphere, that is in K space, so here we are dividing the whole sphere volume by 1/8. This is because we know that, let's say its x axis, its y and its z axis, it's in K space, but for simplicity I am using these x, y and z axis. So we know there is a symmetry in crystal, and we know that if there is Anything at plus k is also available in minus k, at minus k with negative energy. So if we take electron with plus k sign, then it also has the electron with minus k. So if we take whole volume of this k space, this will give us 8 times more number of density states. So for this we have to divide whole volume by 1/8, because here there are 2 states in this direction. So for, let's say for in x direction, we have to divide by half, so that we can only take the one value of from this plus k and minus k. And for other the direction y, there is also minus k y or plus k y. So by taking half of this, we can get the actual number of the states. So for this, we have to divide the whole volume of a sphere by this number, because 1/8 in x direction, 1/2 in x direction, 1/2 in y direction, and 1/2 in z direction. So now we know that what is the volume of sphere, which is equal to 4/3 into pi by kx, ky, and kz. Here we have to divide this volume into 8 or 1/8. So, and here kx equal to ky equal to kz, so we can write this v is equal to, or volume of the available volume is 1/8 into 4/3 into pi into k cube. So this, please don't be confused, this volume in k space, here we are talking only about the energy of the electron. So now we have to calculate so number of states in volume V is, now we know the volume of the K space, which is this one, and we also know the minimum volume required by an electron. So by dividing this V by volume of electron, that is VA, we can get the number of states. So N equal to V by VA. V by VA. So this is very important to note. And again, since each state can has or can have 2 electrons, so ultimately n is equal to double of this number, V by V A. So this is the actual number of density states, because every state can have 2 electrons with opposite spins by using Pauli exclusion principle. And now what is this number, which is equal to 2, we know that what is V? Is 1 by 8 into 4 by 3 into pi k cube, and we know what is VA, that is pi by L cube, so which is ultimately 1 by 3 pi k cube into L cube by pi cube, which is equal to 1 by 3 k cube L cube by pi square. Now we know that density of state, what is density of state mean? That is number of states per unit volume, per unit energy. So for this we have to divide this n by energy and volume, or we have to differentiate n with respect to energy. So for this we can have dn. So first we know that E equal to h square k square by 2m. So we use this relation to prove this one. So first let's take dn by dk, which is equal to 1 by 3 into 3 k square l cube by pi square, which is equal to k square L cube by pi square. And we can also write dn by dE. If we take dn by dE, we can write it as dn by dk into dk by dE. Our main goal is to determine dn by dE, but since there is no energy term is available here, so first we have to differentiate with respect to k, and by making a combination of k and e we can determine this number dn by dE. So we know that equal to h square k square by 2m. So from here we can write, it's very important to note, therefore dn by dE. So the first we have to know the d, this term dE by dk or dk by dE. So it's easy to determine dE by dk, and then we can take the reciprocal of that number. So dE by dk, which is equal to h square by k by m. From here we can write k equal to 2me. From here we can write k equal to 2me h cross k. So now we have a number, that is dE by dk, and we also have dn by dk. So we have to determine this number dn by dk, dn by dE. So we can determine this number dn by dE, which is equal to k square by L cube by pi square into, or
by dividing h square by k into m. So this would be k square l cube by pi square into m over h square k, which is equal to k l cube by pi square h cross square m. So now we get dn by dE. So now what is density of state, which is equal to number of states per unit volume. For per unit volume we have to divide this number by whole volume, or to get per unit energy we have to divide by whole energy. So now, so this is equal to 1 by L cube into K L cube by pi square h square m, which is equal to K, this would be cancelled, into pi square h cross square into m. So from here we can simply write dos, that is equal to k by pi h cross into m. And from the equation e equal to h square k square by 2m, from here we can get the value of k, that is 2me by h square, h cross square, and by putting this k value in this we can write density of state, and this is in 3D because here we are considering all of three axes, which is equal to 2me under the root because here k square and above this is also under root. So we can write it h cube pi m, which is equal to under root 2 m, which is 3 by 2 now, h cube h cross cube and root e. And by putting the value of h cross by in h, we can write it's 8 pi h cube m 3 by 2 into root e. So this is the density of state in 3D. So from here we can see that in 3D density of state directly proportional to under root of the energy. Although we don't need to know about the density of state in nanomaterials like one dimension, two dimension, but if
If we want to determine the density of state in 2D, then we have to use two axes only or two dimension only, that is x or y or xz or yz. Then we can take the area of the minimum area that is required by an electron. Here we are VA, then we use this A term. That would be pi by Lx or pi by Ly. But we don't need that formula. In this course, we only see the properties of bulk materials. So here we get the density of state in three dimensions, that is directly proportional to under root of energy. I hope you will understand this concept, which is very important to determine the number of charge carriers that are available for conduction in a device.